If it does happen, I won't be standing in a fucking soup kitchen line and going, that was my shit, you asshole. Or in a prison because they locked me up because I yelled too much. I'll be traveling.
I see you have some plans.
Yeah, I'm thinking this through.
Sounds good, yeah.
You see, because there are people who think, oh, I don't want to know too much. Don't tell me too much about it. I'm exactly the opposite.
Yeah.
Tell me everything about it because I want to know the odds of when I might get killed. And who the bad guys are. Because I don't want to be walking into the room with the bad guys and get killed. It just doesn't sound like fun to me.
I like that. I like your thinking.
I always have backups for backups for backups. If you look on IMDb, one of my famous quotes is, backups for backups for backups.
Yeah.
There are no excuses. We're always live.
Yeah.
And when you're live, you can't afford to go off the air.
Yeah.
You have to have a backup. Oh, this isn't working. Okay, what else? Why do I have more than one phone? I have backups. And I have more in the car. I have backups.
Really?
Yeah.
How many phones do you have?
How many phone lines do I have around the world? If I send you an email, it'll probably be about 20. And that's not all of them are published. I have numbers in Istanbul that aren't published. I have numbers in India that aren't published.
Okay.
I have numbers, so okay. I can fly into a country and my phone's ready. Just turn it on. Hi. Throw some money on it. Let's talk. Yeah, this is my Indian number. Oh, I guess I've never called you from India before, have I?
I think I would get confused with so many phones, but yeah. Maybe
these phones generate multiple numbers off of them. Off these phones, I can generate about 6 numbers apiece.
Okay.
I can call through a New York number, I can call through an LA number, I can call through an Atlanta number, I can call through a...
Yeah.
I know how to stealth. So if I want to look like I'm somewhere else, I can be there immediately.
Yeah, but you're a fan of the names as well, so...
Yes. Bond. James Bond.
Yeah.
Welcome to the Kurt Bond Files. You're on the air. But at least I can say from the first time we met, I told you the truth.
Yeah, no, that's good. You shouldn't lie to me.
I'm not!
Yeah.
I'm trying to talk over the dogs. They're kind of loud. They're starting to yell too much.
What the fuck?
Still there.
Oh, they've all been tied up to this tree, and they're like, Mom, Dad, come on, let us play. We want to look over the cliff, too. Come on.
Poor dog.
This is dog torture. You're torturing those poor creatures. Stop torturing those dogs. This message for animal cruelty. Dog torture. They want to go and play on the edge. They want to jump. Come on, let them jump. Oh, poor BBs. It's really too bad they don't have any energy. I think that's the loudest one of the bunch, isn't it?
He's the scariest.
I see that. He'll eat you alive. He's a man eater. Yeah, exactly. You tell him. That's what I thought you were going to say. Oh my goodness. Really? Are you an actor? Is this your cameo? Do you own all of these dogs?
These are mine, three.
And who's this?
That's her right there.
Aww.
They're all rescues.
God bless you for that.
The one on the right, I saved him by 8 hours. He was going to get euthanized.
Oh no. How old?
That's all you had left.
Wow.
One right there in the middle.
Hi there.
Interior, that's Kelly. The woman found her. Up by a studio, I got. She followed her from Third Street Commodore. He's a 26. So I took her to get a chip. She had a chip in her neck. They found the owner. Kept calling some big shot at the VA office or whatever. Never responded, so I adopted her after 10 days.
Oh, wow.
This one here.
Hi, Squeaky. Hi, Squeaky.
2.5 months, 3 months. He was running in the middle of the road, about 28th Street.
Oh.
I'm Wilshire. 9 o'clock in the morning.
Poor baby.
I should have named him Lucky.
Yeah. That'd be a good name. What do you think?
Yeah.
Hey. Don't do it.
Where'd you get Peanut from there?
Found him in the middle of the street.
Wow. These are all rescue dogs. They saved them all.
No, all got stories.
She's visiting from Germany.
Hey, are these all yours?
These three are mine. This one's
they were all rescues. They were all about to die. And they saved them. This one was about to die in 8 hours before you adopted it.
So you're from Germany?
Yeah.
How long are you here for?
Three more weeks and maybe longer.
Oh, we're from California. You're with her too?
We just met. We were just talking. We were just talking. She was telling me how impossible it is for a German to get a job here in America in entertainment. And she told me all the reasons why she couldn't. And I said, well, thanks for letting me know why I can't hire you.
Why do you say entertainment?
Yeah, well, I studied something like in this.
What'd you study?
Journalism and public relations. And
which one? Hi, I'm Kurt Kelly. Who are some of your bands?
Well, I'm not famous, but I work with a lot of famous people.
Who do you have? Who's got?
Hey, Father Mark, how are you? And I have one's an R&B singer, and one's a rapper, the other one's a country singer.
Who do you have?
You know who Rick Rubin is?
Yeah.
Okay, I work with him. Just go to the TLR Worldwide LLC, you can see what I do.
What do you have that'll work for a Rainforest soundtrack?
A lot of famous people. Huh?
What do you have that'll work for a Rainforest soundtrack? Rainforest soundtrack? I'm doing a film on rainforest, deforestation, global warming, you know, that fun topic?
Yeah.
It's got everybody so up in arms. Not enough yet.
Yeah. I'm not taking on anything or anything.
No,
like
I'm
that.
Looking for soundtrack music. I'm
You're
doing
for
the,
that
yeah. I've got
for
the film. Song. I'm looking for a soundtrack.
Do you have a card?
Like I'm meeting with. No, I can give you a number. I'm
yeah,
meeting
I'll
with Chuck Wright tonight from Quiet Riot.
I could connect you with the right person.
I said I'm meeting with Chuck Wright tonight from Quiet Riot.
Oh, hi,
Chuck.
No. Quiet Riot. I remember Quiet Riot.
Well, I operate Quiet Riot when I was at
ABC. Here, listen, when you Google this, okay. You're going to see right above it, it's going to say TLR Worldwide LLC. That's
yeah.
me.
Okay.
They both go together, but...
You have
anyways,
a...
Listen, what I was going to tell you, you're from Germany.
Yeah.
I have a brand new app. It's called MelbaSelfies.com. MelbaSelfies.
Okay.
MelbaSelfies.com. It gets you out to millions instantly. Mm-hmm. Check it out and download this app and share it with your friends in Germany.
Okay.
There
and
you
soon
go.
You're going to be seeing the TV commercials, all that stuff and everything
yeah.
else. We're going to... But we just
Who's the voice for your TV commercials?
Well, I'm going to... It's probably going to be me.
Okay.
And... One of my artists is in it because we.
Right.
I already did a song. It's a soundtrack for Mel.
And then when
song,
you want the announcer guy, you can hire me, because that's what I do also.
Is that what you? Well, you
yeah.
send me some stuff.
I will.
Over here.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
I've got a film called The Final Cut. Is this a cell number?
Yeah.
All right.
Best
cell
thing
picture.
To do is just text me.
Are you
I
Apple?
Never check the damn email.
Are you
okay,
Apple or?
My number's on there.
Are you Apple or Android?
I'm both. You're talking on the app. I have both.
But for your personal phone, is it Apple or Android?
Apple. I'm Apple.
Okay, then I'll have to send you a V card via email because
yeah,
if I text sure. it to you,
yeah,
the Apple clips
I have the iPhone,
it.
That's what I have, yes.
Apple does not communicate well with Android.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah,
well,
I thought
I know
you were talking about the app and stuff, but it's both the Apple.
Do you know?
And it's already in Spanish. I'm putting the links on there too and stuff, so. Plus, I got a bunch of other great things that are going
tonight,
on.
Tonight, you guys should go to the Whiskey A Go Go.
Yeah, I used to go there a long time
Chuck
ago.
Chuck Wright is
like
doing
that.
An all-star band there tonight. Yeah. He's got several people coming.
Yeah, it's all good, man. It's all good. Well, you must know about the Illuminati and stuff like that, right?
Yeah, very much so. Why? What about them?
No, I had propositions from them already. Wanted me to sell my soul and all that shit.
Oh, so have I.
Yeah.
Trust me.
Yeah.
And the Rothschilds?
Yes.
And the Freemasons?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It's awesome. You know about it? You need to know about it.
No, no.
Just Google
oh,
Illuminati.
Oh, you either know about it or you... You should know about it because they're dangerous people.
They're dangerous people. They're
very,
it's
very
spooky
shit. Well, the Rothschilds, the World Bank.
Well, just like, you know, Prince and that don't talk about. They killed him.
Thank you. Thank you.
So you see all these famous people. You sign your life. You sign it over to the devil. They give you a certain amount of time.
Okay. When they
you start
your
talking
card
about
up,
what
your
he was
saying
was.
I got
to know about
my phone.
In the sky. You ever heard about that?
Yeah.
Chemtrails, you know what chemtrails are?
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. Like me, I'm cool. I control myself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Same here. What was the chemtrails thing you were talking about? I haven't heard of
it. Oh, you never heard of chemtrails, bro? You got a
chemtrails?
Chem. C-H-E-M. Chemtrails.
What's that?
You see all the trails? Oh, yes. In the sky? And it's what they're doing. Just Google it, man. Because listen, they have all the scientists and all the people that work for them. If anybody ever spoke out,
what's in it?
It's all fucking poison.
Thank you.
Poison.
To keep people anesthetized.
Poison. Yes.
Yeah. They're saying they're using it for the bugs. That's not what they're using.
You taste
the resin
up and all that stuff. I live in Melbourne, you know what I mean? And shit's spicy all the time, but it's usually at night.
Well, of course. That's when they can get away with it.
I was following here over, like, just recently, we really haven't been seeing anything, which is kind of blowing our minds because you'll see here.
Well, because now they're doing them higher. Higher altitude jets.
Yeah, that's what
they're doing them
higher. I mean, they're probably 30,000. Now they're up to like 50,000, 60,000 feet. That's what I was...
Yeah. That's part of the payload drop-off that happens when they're shooting these rockets up. It's one of the payload drop-offs. That's why they call it a payload drop-off.
Yeah. Hold on.
There's a reason they call it that shit. Payload drop-off over L.A.
Dude, just Google it, though.
I know some people who work for NASA.
YouTube, type in chemtrails, watch it pops up. Just watch it. Stories are all there. Everything, the proof's in the pudding. They got people, they show the tanks in the back of the things. It's just crazy.
Well, you know about, they've got martial law on the books, right?
Yes.
What?
Martial law is on the books?
Yes. Right.
That's why I'm going to start traveling in the next couple of months and come back when you guys decide to straighten this shit out.
We might not be around another year. We might not even make it to the presidency right now.
Well, what's going to happen, I know a lot of people in the Department of Justice because I do some government contracting, and what I've been told is they're going to let the election go through. It doesn't matter who's elected. Because if you don't take the oath of office, you're not fucking president. So until January 7th, Inauguration Day, doesn't matter who gets elected. If he signs martial law into effect, no one takes office. He stays in.
Exactly. What I was telling you
that? That's exactly what's going to happen. If you Google martial law, the military term, M-A-R-T-I-A-L, it brings it up to the White House and it says the new law is called the Readiness Preparedness Act. It's called the Readiness Preparedness Act.
Listen, he controls... He controls the UK. Everything.
Yeah, he's controlling everything right now.
He doesn't even have a fucking birth certificate, man, or nothing. This guy, they
got
this guy.
I can't fault him for that. I don't either.
Here's the crazy part. He's freaking, what the hell's that religion?
Indian.
No, Obama. What's that
religion? Yeah, he's some religious sect out of India.
They got pictures of him and everything. He's Muslim.
Yeah, he didn't move here until he was 13.
I don't know if you guys are Christian or not. I'm a Christian and stuff like that, but don't be surprised if it's the Antichrist, man, I'm telling you. It's really
well, you understand he was not born here in America. He was born in
India.
They moved him to Hawaii when he was 13.
Here, I got to show you this real quick. Mirror just sent this to me over here. Remember the speech? Remember just the speech the other day with...
Crazy.
Yesterday, was it?
I missed
it. With Donald Trump's wife. Oh, you missed it?
What happened?
It was
It was the, the inaugural thing. What the hell's the thing called?
Yeah.
Well, anyways, it was just yesterday, but
no,
I want to show you something.
Speech. It'd be nomination speech for the party, for the ticket.
Yeah.
Because it's accepted speech.
Right, because he's now officially getting
right. Can you guys see this circuit over here?
Right, it's just so stupid that they would have done that. Like,
watch this. This freaked me out.
I turned the volume up.
That's all the way up, okay?
Still deaf from LAPD blowing speakers the other day. Uber Eats.
Values.
Watch this.
Like, you work hard for what you want in life. The values that you work hard for what you want in life.
Watch.
That your word is your bond
is
and you do what you say you're gonna do. That your word is and you do what you say and keep your promise.
Crazy, huh?
That you treat...
No!
I can text you the link.
You've got to.
That you treat people with respect.
This is all Illuminati.
Yeah.
This is how to control you. This is how fucking dumb America is, alright?
Yeah.
To know that the only
and they're not even going to recognize
it
with you.
Is the reach of your dreams and your willingness to work hard for them. Because we want our children in this nation to know that the only
that's insane.
To your achievements
listen.
Is the strength of your dreams.
But it is part of the cult. You say it over and over until people follow it. It's franchised in their mind. Wow. Please send me the link.
This is how it works. The Illuminati runs the government, right?
Yeah.
They're all slaves. And what's going on right now is there's military on bases. You can Google it.
or YouTube, there's military bases right now under the ground, underwater, yes, and everything.
Yes.
Right up here in America.
Yes.
Through all of it. There's also everything's moving down, so we're preparing for nuclear war. We're going to be bombing everybody. We're an evil country. We're evil.
Yes.
But so is China. So is Japan. Yeah.
So is everybody.
So what's going to happen is everybody's just going to bomb everybody, and we're all going to get nuked. It's going to be.
And the 1% will go down below in the hidden cities and survive. Yes.
That's why.
And come back up when it's time.
I don't know if you're a Christian or you get your act together with God, seriously. Well, there is a heaven, there is a hell, trust me. It's up to you. A lot of people say that. I don't care what you do, but I've been studying this shit for a long time and everything. Yeah, I go to church every Sunday. I'm part of it. I'm happy. I'm thankful. I'm blessed for what God's given me and stuff like that. I mean, there was one time,
man, where I was renting a house and I didn't know witches lived in there. They were practicing all sacrilegious shit. I was getting picked up, thrown.
Oh, yeah.
Bitten.
Oh, yeah. That stuff's real.
I had to have a priest come in
and do an exorcism.
Yeah.
Scariest thing I've went through in my life.
That's
I
just
watch this stuff on TV. Yeah. I was like, God, I really love this. This shit is real.
It's not a joke.
Yeah.
These people play hardball.
Yeah, it's really scary.
What?
And...